Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a BMW guys 3 series. I'm talking about generation E90, 91, 92, 93. And if you're guys trying to find your front crash airbag sensors, stay with us. We'll explain guys where they're located and what you need to expect to get them and replace them if you need to do that. We need to share very helpful information with you. Make sure you stay until the end because airbags can kill you guys. Now, before we start, that should work on generation E90, I said, to E93, so that will cover years BMW 3 Series 2005 to year 2013. Well, let me tell you guys one thing. If you need to buy any parts, tools for your BMW 3 Series, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where you can get tools and parts from for a really good price and fast shipping. That's where we get ours from, guys. Another thing, every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission here at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Now, let me show you where it's located. First, I will not recommend to work on the airbag system unless you're qualified or certified to do that, because airbags can kill you guys. So consider this entertaining video and not a how-to video. That being said guys, number one thing, when you work on airbag system, what do we usually do? Okay, and always consult your manual too guys. Disconnect the car battery for at least 1 hour before you guys start on it. That way the airbag system can discharge and the chance for something terrible to happen will be less likely. It's still possible, but less likely guys. Another thing, number two guys, on these modern cars it really matters which car battery terminal you disconnect first, positive or negative. If you don't do it the right way, you can severely damage guys your electrical system, burn computers, engine computer, body computer, airbag computer even guys. We've done that in the past. We messed up airbag computer because of that and it cost us $2,000 because you didn't disconnect it and reconnect it the car battery the correct way. So I will put a link to a video in the description below guys that explains actually how to guys properly disconnect car battery. Check it out, and how to properly reconnect it, which is even more important. Now, that being said, with that BMW 3 Series completely taken apart, okay, let me explain guys, okay, where the airbag sensors are located. On some cars, you know, they're usually on the radiator support, okay, or behind the radiator support. On these BMWs, guys, okay, they're hidden. And they're right here, guys. Okay, you can see this is the fender. This is where your headlight will be. Fender bumper here. Okay, and check it out now. If you come right here underneath this device, okay, right here, this is your airbag crash sensor guys on the front. Okay, and you have guys, okay, we just have a new company here at the shop, a new cat that decided to adopt us guys, so he's a little bit curious. You will see him probably in quite a few videos. And now let me show you, this is the airbag sensor. It has two screws that you will need to remove, and this one is with torque screw guys. We'll put the links to the tools in the description of the video below. You have to disconnect the wire after the battery is disconnected and all that stuff. You can see you need to press right here, remove these two. Okay, let's see which actually torque screw it is, and we'll continue. So this is it guys, torque 30, so we're going to come underneath and we'll just go ahead and remove the two screws guys. Once everything is disconnected, and you need to connect it and install it later at exactly the same position and way that it was guys. So we're going to take them off now. They either have rust or tread locker, one of the two, so we'll see, because they don't go as easy as they should. They do have some corrosion that I can notice. Okay, one of them is almost out. Perfect. While we're removing the second one, I'm going to explain about that. Well, just a little bit of corrosion where the sensor is right here, but otherwise no corrosion on the bolt. That's what it looks like. Now we're going to work on the second one. Okay, and we'll be ready soon with that crash front impact airbag sensor guys. If you have any recommendations, questions, anything that you want to see video about, leave a comment below, and when we have a time guys, we'll try to make a video for your specific problem or replicate it, so that way Most of you will know, okay, what to do if you have something like that. And second board is out, and this is, guys, your crash front airbag sensor. This is the one on the driver's side. This is the screw. You can see this one does have tread locker. I guess the other one did too, but it's not noticeable. So always apply tread locker. I'll put the link in the description of the video below. And hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful. If you have any questions, again, just let us know and we'll try to make a video when we have a chance. The other one is located right here, okay, on the passenger side. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.